Alright, second day. Yeah, you're not gonna hear me very well because of the grinding sound. Okay, what's my plan? Yesterday I was thinking, and today also I was thinking, that they said to me, do not open back here because they need bleeding and need some special thing or something. Even if I don't open it, I have already removed the fork that's coming here, and this using hydraulic pressure from back there. Except of this, as I said, to remove this that's broken, I have to remove the pin, the axle back. So it's a must open, and I will open. When are we gonna open? I'm gonna understand how it's working, let us say the pump, how it's pressurizing the fluid. Most probably it's keeping it on this container, then it's passing through the solenoids, and each solenoid from the paths that has, from where it's passing, let us say you have this one, you have this one, you have, and from the other, in the other case you have also the O-rings, that it's much more easy to understand where it's going. So, and this is what I'm planning to do. I'm gonna open it to understand, write down how it's working in a paper, strip off the transmission. I don't care too much about the bearings, because the bearings I can find in the market. It's not something extremely. From what I saw, there is a part number on it, and it's a Koyo bearings, so definitely you're gonna find the bearings. Synchronized gears, I have an idea. I believe it's gonna work. You're gonna find out later on. The oil pump, this is a different story. That's a different story. We're gonna see about that. So, yes, let's open completely. Let's open completely and think after that, see what's going on. Because I have no choice. As I said, what I'm gonna change the synchronized gears here for the four gears, and the other four, what are gonna be the old one? Make no sense. Let's start it. I just now opened the solenoids here, back what has, alright? So it looks like it doesn't matter if you open this piece here, but take a look what I saw. That's why it was grinding the gears, because I said, okay, it's the synchronized gears, alright? There is a problem, alright. But how you can say that, how you can explain this, the chips here. I mean, how it was not completely, you know, it doesn't make any sense. This piece is here, that means also there, that means it was out of alignment, and the thrust washer that has here on this gear, that's broken, because that's the other gear. Why is that? All these bolts, they're loose. One bolt is here, down here. This bolt is loose, this bolt is loose. Honestly, I don't know who's gonna believe it or not, I didn't touch these bolts, I just now opened it. I don't even have the Allen, no, maybe I have the Allen for this one, but I didn't touch it. I just remove this, the yoke. I remove also this one for the bracket for the engine, for the transmission mount. Open all the Allen, and just now I split in the middle. Go figure out. That means it's not in place, it's supposed to move, because all of them, this was down there. Just like that. Let's get one Allen. Let's see this one. Yeah, this is obviously. And has also Loctite. These are the pieces that I found. That's why it was looks like this. This is like a washer to secure down this. If you watch the previous video to see, because I have it now in the other warehouse. I'm gonna go to the C14 to have a look. There are some small pieces. This from this. All right. That's a good news. I can handle the synchronized gears, the clutch on the synchronized gears. I can handle the bearings. I can even handle this one. There is no problem. Splendid. Great news. I'm gonna see what I'm gonna do with that. We're gonna figure it out. First, let's fix this one. And when I finish everything with the transmission, and it's nice, then we're gonna start with that.
Take a look, I was not expecting that. Let's see this one. Yeah, it's loose. Splendid, beautiful. No, it's not splendid, it's not good, but okay, it happened, but imagine don't open this. I said okay, anyhow, if it is, now there is another one, small issue, because here it comes this, and this one, you see it's been worn out, that means this came too much back, since came too much back, this gear, one second, slowly, alright, this gear, it touched on this thrust washer that has here and break it. And all this happened because it was moving inside the gears, the input shaft and the secondary shaft, counter shaft, I don't know how to call it this in English. So, yeah, nice, that's amazing news. We're gonna have a test drive at the end, definitely. Continue, that's very good. I'm very happy, I'm super happy. And as I said, I'm gonna show you one trick. If I'm right, it's gonna be an easy fix for this, to change this. I think that's matching from one car. Let's see. What's remaining, the oil pump. Alright, continue. Very good. I'm gonna go to bring the pieces. I'm gonna get the camera and go there. No, I'm gonna bring the pieces here. To compare the washer, what I said. To compare this. Yeah. So, this is the part that it broke. You can see on the previous video, that's the part that I found inside. And then I found also these small pieces. You can check actually the previous video. Alright, so there was also this piece. These pieces are this is, you can see here, that's missing. You can see even here, that's missing. One complete, here. This is complete, this is how it's supposed to be. This is how it's supposed to be. And all the bolts, there was loose. Okay. This one, I just want to count this one, because this didn't fail because of the gear or because of any other reason. This failed because it hit to the other gear that's located down over there. So, because it can move backwards, it move, it touch it here, and it break it. I have to open the bolt, actually. Yeah. That's it. Next video, when we're gonna find the parts, when we're gonna wash everything, and we're gonna prepare everything, I'm gonna make the other video. That's it for now. Thank you. Okay. Where are we now? The belt housing, the front piece, nice and washed. This already prepared. And from the other side, obviously. I have to open a couple of small things, already blow everywhere. From where it's passing the oil, from everything. Here is the, this is where I was saying, also this is the other piece. Okay, the input shaft. This is, I don't know how it's called, this shaft. Yeah, this is the output shaft. Yeah, go figure out. All this time. Alright, this is the other piece. This is where I'm saying that here it's located the sensor that I was saying before. There is one sensor here. And then the fork. There is one magnet. And this one, it's here inside. And when it's moving, it's reading it. By the way, the forks are okay, there is no problem. The bearings, I want to change the bearings. It didn't overheat, but what happened? As I said before on the previous video, this plate, it was loose. This bolt was out. You can see the washers, how they end up. One bolt was fell down and the other was loose. This one was not keeping the both shafts in place. So there was moving front and back. You can see here that they're missing. It's been scratched here.
it's been scratched even here. Talking about there.
You can see not only there, you can see the same thing, let us say, on this gear that's been running on this bearing, was touching on this bearing. On this surface here, it's sharp actually. Okay. I mean, if you compare this bearing with this bearing, you understand what I'm saying. This was running on this surface, because the both axles, one second, put back again, yeah, because both axles can make this movement, front, back, and front, back. So it was make this movement, it was touching everything, and then you can see also some gears here, the same story. Some of them are sharp here. Yeah, you saw in the previous video this. I saw this on the previous video. So what's my plan now? Repeat for that. I need to change the oil pump, and they inform me that it's coming, the oil pump. We can find the oil pump. That's a good news. I'm not afraid about the bearings. It's not something crazy. Definitely we can find the bearings. Synchronized gears, we already found synchronized gears, so I'm planning to change 1, 2, 3, 4 to finish the story. On this one, because I pulled it out, it came out the spring and the balls. On this one, this comes here. Actually, this is what happened also with that, but first I wash it and then I put it together to be nice in place. And this is what I'm planning to do also with that. First I'm gonna wash it, I haven't washed it yet. I'm gonna wash it and then I'm gonna put this back in place as it was to have a look on it. So what else? Yeah, pretty much that's it. Not bad. I have to finish a couple of things like here because there is the stupid glue. Then I saw also this piece. This here has been welded. But this looks like it's from the factory. Why I'm saying that? Maybe there was a problem with the casting. You can see some imperfections here up. But if you see from outside, it doesn't have any heat. If you see inside the hole, it does look like that somebody touched it, or even here. This surface, it's been machined, and it's not, let us say, that they resurfaced again or something. And it does look like that somebody touched before the transmission. So I believe that this was from the factory. Yeah, it's not a big deal. It's not something crazy. This is fine. I have to check also. It's not fine actually. I have to clean also here from the old gasket maker sealant. What in hell is that stupid thing? Nice. So yeah, pretty much that's it. As I said, when I'm gonna receive bearings, oil pump, synchronized gears, and when I'm ready to assemble to put back together, then I'm gonna start the camera. This is the thrust washer, the puzzle, that this, as I said, touches on the gear. This touches on, not on this gear, this touches, I think, on this gear, if I'm right. Yep. Yes. And brake. What else? I need also a couple of O-rings. I need to change it because it's full of sealant, gasket maker. What the hell is that shit? So yeah, that's it. Nice, not bad. Thank you very much. What do you need for my life? What do you need standing there? I didn't turn off the camera, tell me what. Yes, health report. Okay, I'm on it.